answer, I'm going to learn same as to continue what we started to say to learn the state of matter. How our state of matter can change by the temperature. So coming to learn how it will change, what are the processes after we already learned in that. See here, what is first we learn? Melting. What we learn? Melting. Into that melting, learn about changing is our engagement. Changing a solid into a liquid. Solid liquid is called melting. Same time, one more what we discussed that. So, freezing. Freezing. And also in this we know fusion. So freezing. Of course, we are discussing solidification. What is that? Solidification. Or frozen. What we discussed? Solidification or frozen or freezing. What is the meaning of solidification? What we discussed? Changing a liquid to solid. What we discussed? Changing a liquid to solid is called what we can solidification. What we discuss here? Solidification. On cooling a liquid, what we can discuss? On cooling a liquid means by decreasing the temperature. So the kinetic energy of the particles decreases, what we can discuss? The kinetic energy of the particle decreases, particle decreases, and then attractive force becomes stronger, and then attractive force means intermolecular force becomes stronger. So the particle comes closer like in a solid. The particles comes closer like a solid. Like a solid. So that's why what happened? The liquid is said to be solidified and become solid and cooling. But we can say thus liquid, but we can say there is a liquid is said to solidify. But we can solidify and becomes a solid on cooling. See one thing what we are discussing from that. On cooling, what happened? The space between the molecules are going to decrease. By that, what happened? Kinetic energy decreases and then what we can attract force becomes stronger. So the substance which is becomes solid, that we are calling as a solidifier. What is that? Solidifier. Understand? Coming to talk, one more thing we already discussed is that is something as vaporization. What we discussed here, vaporization. So what we can observe here during vaporization, changing what we can, a liquid into a gas. Coming to by on heating, what happened? On heating this process, kinetic energy, what happened? The kinetic energy we can show as KE. So on heating, kinetic energy increases. Means space between the molecules, space between, what we can say, space between molecule increases, space between molecules increases. Okay, then if the molecule first become smaller, what we can say, intermolecular force become smaller. Okay, by that what happened? They change into what we can say gas state. That changing we can call like vaporize. We can say vaporize, which is the liquid changing into gases. That liquid we can call vaporize. What we call the liquid which is participating in the vaporization process, that liquid we can call as a vaporizer. So in melting process, what happened? In melting process, we are going to on heating. What happened? Heating. On heating, what happened? So kinetic energy increases, kinetic energy increases. So same as intermolecular space is more than intermolecular force is small, means less. Okay, coming to what we can, but which is changing into liquid from solid, that we are calling as a melting. What we are calling, the solid which is changing into liquid, that we are calling as a melt. Understand? See, these whole we already discussed. So which are we discussed? Melting, freezing, of course, solidification, what is that? And vaporization, boiling, such as those. Then what we discussed, the solid state is changing into liquid state is changing into the gas state. Again we discussed gas state is changing into the liquid state is changing to the solid state. Then, what we have to discuss, if the solid state is directly converting to the gas state, if the solid state is directly converting to the gas state, then gas state is directly converting to the solid state. Then what to make of that? We talk in right now. the best coming to know. Yeah. So coming to talk from last class, solid state is directly converting to the gaseous state. But we can solid state is directly converting to the gaseous state. That we may call sublimation. What is that? Sublimation. Sublimation is the process to change the solid state of substance direct into the gaseous state. It is the process, what we can say, it is the process.
Coming to that, what we can
Does the sun exist to me? Does the sun is set to be means the solid which is changing into the gases from solid directly, that is said to be a set to something. Sublime, what we get to become a gas, to become a gas without first becoming, without first becoming what we can, a liquid. A liquid. Without changing into liquid state, the solid state of substance directly change into the gas state. So, by the in this process, what we observe, the intermolecular flow, what we can, intermolecular space is more, means increases. Examples of the sublimate substances, not for that, naphthalene, camphor, carbon dioxide, means solid carbon dioxide, carbon dioxide means that is a dry ice, that is nothing as dry ice, etc. can change directly into the gas state from solid state. So to change any state from one state to another state of the substance, it needs temperature and pressure. Pressure and temperature is necessary to change the state of substance. To change the state of substance, which are necessary, pressure and temperature. Some of this we'll discuss one more process.
Okay.
Coming to talk what we discussed. So before we discussed melting, okay, means to solid state to liquid state, and one more point we discussed, freezing, solidification from liquid to solid, and vaporization. What we discussed now, of course, in that we discussed boiling also. So from liquid state to gas state. And coming to that liquefaction or condensation, or otherwise what we can say is, what we can liquefaction, okay, is nothing as gas entry to liquid state, and this we call again solidification. What we can solidification. And coming to that, what we discussed, liquid to gas and gas to liquid, okay, and those sublimation, what we discussed, sublimation, from that we discussed sublimation, so solid state is directly converting to the gas state. Now what we are saying, hot frost, what is that, hot frost is a gas state of substance directly changed into the solid state of substance. Cold frost is a process to change the gas state of substance directly to the solid state of substance. See, coming to part in this situation, what solid to liquid to gas state, in this situation, heat or what you can say, temperature is gained, what we can say is gained or received or absorbed. Okay, and in this situation, what we can say, from gas state to liquid state to what we can say solid state, what happens? Heat or temperature is liberated. Understand? Get not on one softly, we'll discuss some more. So what we discussed from that, see here, this is a solid state and this is what I'm saying to you, liquid state and this is gaseous state. Is that visible? Three states we are talking. When solid state is directly, of course solid state is converted into liquid state, but we call melting. Okay, when liquid state is changed to the solid state that we call freezing. Melting and freezing. The liquid state is changed to the gaseous state is evaporation. What we can say? See, coming to call. What is that? Evaporation. Then gas state change into the liquid state is condensation. What is that? Condensation. When solid state is directly changed into the gas state, that we are calling sublimation. And when gas state is directly changed into solid, that we call cold frost. Otherwise, deposition. What we can say, this is deposition. Okay, this is our fixed argument. Okay, coming to talk, what we already discussed, just an example. What we can, best example for what for best example for the matter which can exist in three states. Three states is what man? Water. Because solid state of water is ice, liquid state of water, of course, water, and gaseous state of water is water vapor. Understand? So none of these properties we will discuss again. Some more properties. So property intermolecular adsorption means intermolecular force. Intermolecular force. And coming to that, intermolecular space, intermolecular space, intermolecular space. And coming to that, kinetic energy. Kinetic energy of molecules. And coming to that, potential, what we can say, potential energy of molecules. Kinetic energy, potential energy. For solid state, liquid state, gas state. Is that visible? What you get? Solid state, liquid state, gas state. Is that clear to visible? Coming to talk about that, for solid state, liquid state, gas state. So intermolecular force, what we get? So solid state having maximum, okay, and liquids are having less. These are having minimum. What we get? Minimum. And coming to talk, intermolecular space for solids is minimal, more, maximum. Okay, this one set of molecules coming to talk. So kinetic energy of the molecules are having minimum. So what is this? Is minimum. So in medium, what we can say, in between. Medium means between. And we have a maximum. And potential energy having maximum. And we have in medium means between, and we have in minimum. Okay? These are the simple properties. Before us, we discuss the properties. So, note on this. So think about what you finished in your online test. So see you in the next class. Have a good day to you.